Is that? Wait. So I see Ganyu, Shenhe, and is that Yao Yao? All right. Some friends have arrived.
Hello, friends.
Yeah, always asleep, that girl. Or at least always dozing off. I don't remember the last time I saw Yao Yao in the cutscene. Or even Shenhe for that matter. You see Shenhe take out a small green bottle, extract some minty smelling liquid, and apply it to Ganyu's horns. Yao Yao and Paimon looking on in shock, mouths agape, but cannot stop her in time. Uh oh. Seems like it, yeah. On the dot.
I could never. I'm sorry. I seem to have missed your name. You are
Gaming.
Me? My name is Gaming. I work as a guard for the Secure Transport Agency.
Gaming. The name sounds familiar. I believe I've heard your name mentioned around the Ministry of Civil Affairs. People tell me you're an extremely enthusiastic worker, and you are very generous with your help.
Well, you know me. Or, I guess you don't.
My name is Ganyu. This is Shenhe, and this is Yao Yao.
It's an honor to finally meet you all. Oh, you must be here for Auntie Xianyun's kite-making workshop, right?
Yes. I have neither made nor flown a kite before. As long as Master is willing to teach, I am willing to learn.
Me too! I want to participate in the kite flying competition with my best friend! Plus, it's more meaningful if you make the kite yourself, right?
True.
Your best friend didn't come with you? Well, Chi-Chi's been super busy helping Dr. Raiju lately.
Yeah.
I'll meet up with her later and give her a huge surprise!
Aw, Yao Yao, you're so sweet.
Wow, you're really thoughtful.
Yeah.
As for myself, I'm afraid I lack some of my companion's enthusiasm. I was originally planning to buy a ready-made kite and just enjoy the festive city atmosphere with everyone. But Cloud Retainer is always going out of her way.
her juniors, wanting us to have the best there is. She always puts us before herself.
That's true.
It was so thoughtful of her to arrange this workshop, so I simply couldn't let such consideration go to waste. My motivation for being here might be a little different, yes. But I'm ready to put in just as much effort as everyone else.
Well, we're all here, but where the heck is Xianyun? Shouldn't she be here by now?
Yeah.
Who is it that speaks of oneself in such an ill-tempered tone?
Master stopped to buy grilled tiger fish to share with everyone. Come get it while it's warm. Shuyu. Look at Final's eyes. Cloud Retainer sits down her bed while Shuyu hands out the grilled fish. As everyone begins to talk, a lively conversation fills the usually tranquil environment of Mount Aocang. Complete, eh? You didn't just help out. What can I say? I was helpful till the very end.
One will wait under this tree and avail oneself of the cool air while one digests. Do not hesitate to seek one's company if you have any trouble, questions, or simply want to chat.
Right. Alright, let's speak with everyone. Alright, so Xianyun and Yao Yao, Shuyu and Drumming.
Gentle.
Okay.
Down to the touch with no discernible temperature. No, not unlike certain medicinal plants I've eaten before. Still, Ganyu appears to be shaking like a cat whose whiskers have just been touched. I should stop. I see. Then I'll apply the oil to your forehead next time.
Oh, no need. I'll just refrain from taking afternoon naps outdoors.
Oh, yeah? How?
Anyway, we should probably get started on our kite. It won't be long before Cloud Retainer comes to check on our progress. Perhaps we should just choose the most traditional style.
Okay.
Well, they seem to be getting along swimmingly.
Yeah. Alright, so Shenhe and Ganyu. A trombo. Can we talk to them more?
The scissor-tailed swallow sure takes a lot of hurt bamboo rods to build.
What?
It broke.
Oh, come on. Alright. Draw me and show you, right?
Hey, Gami! Want to team up?
Huh? Did I have to participate? I thought I'd be done for the day after adjusting the dye formula.
You're that unenthused by kite-making, huh? That doesn't seem like you.
No, it's not that. It's just...
It's just what?
It would take too long to explain. I guess I'll just make one then.
Alright.
What shape should we go with? How about a butterfly?
Butterfly. The butterfly symbolizes the desire for freedom. Perhaps that's also what Jamin's searching for.
What do you think, Xuyu? Is there a particular design you want?
I want a swan!
Swan?
That might be a little hard to pull off.
True, but I still want to try. They're super cute.
Okay, it's decided then.
And quite fitting, considering the fact that Jamin's wushu dance is to represent the solitary swanee with manzai. Can we talk to them some more?
Gami, can I do the coloring?
Sure. I'll go ahead and make the frame for you.
Nice, nice, nice. Alright, and last but not least, Xianyun and Oh Yao Yao.
Very good. Your frame is nice and sturdy. This design, is it a finch?
Yep.
Oh, nice, Yao Yao.
One is looking forward to seeing your finished product.
What color are you going to make it, Yao Yao?
I haven't decided yet. If I make it blue, it'll be more like my friend. But if I make it gold, it'll be more like me.
Right.
If you are asking for one's own opinion, one would advise choosing gold.
Yeah.
When giving a gift, the key consideration is the recipient's feelings, is it not?
Mm-hmm.
One imagines your friend would much prefer a kite that reminds them of you.
Oh, hey, I never told you the kite was for Chi-Chi. How did you know?
Because she has a... unwarranted special hearing earplugs, you know, the last generation up to date. She didn't hear from a mile away.
With age comes wisdom, child.
That's
one
it.
Simply has a way of knowing things.
Also, I just hid behind the behind a rock and just heard your conversation. So yeah, there's that too. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs.
We actually haven't started yet, but we're going to start, right now.
Let's book.
We should get started on our kite now. Let's go.
Yeah? And how? Where? Wait, are the designs starting to... Oh no. Seem like it. Wait, I still want to hear this.
Once I get better at making kites, I'm going to make one shaped like you would like. You gave him to me, and he's just the best.
One is pleased that you like the gift.
Motherly love from Xianyun. Amazing. Alright, start making our beautiful kite.
First, we have to decide on the shape. Hey, what are you laughing at?
Hmm. The obvious answer is to make a Paimon-shaped kite. Yeah. Yeah. Sure thing. Of a traveler. Travelers, not sure about that. But still. You build a tight frame according to Cloud Retainer's instructions. Okay, not bad.
What expression should we give her? Since the kite is going to be flying super high in the sky.
Well, she can fly, so. Yeah, she should look pleased with herself.
Ooh, like this? The title
of Champion Kite Flyer is mine! Yeah, that's
the one. Now that we've decided, let's make it
seems like it, yeah? And Xianyun is actually moving.
Alright, gather around everyone.
Alright, sure.
Oh, Xianyun's calling us!
Let one take a look.
Yep. The coloring makes it look a lot like Master.
Yeah.
If the tail wasn't split in two like that, it might even be a spitting image. If you look closely, there are a few spots where the colors go outside the line. Did you doze off while painting it on you?
I did the painting.
Paimon, shut up. Paimon, do not speak another word.
I stared at the paper for quite some time, but I simply could not recall the coloring of any bird. Except Master. Or should I say that I'm too familiar with her crane form? Even when she stands before us in human form, all I can see is blue and white.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I simply closed my eyes and painted from memory.
Awesome.
No way. You can paint with your eyes closed? Wow. The disciples of Adepti really are something.
Truly.
You are most filthy, Shenhe. One is flattered by the likeness.
The swami that Gaomeng and Shuyu made looks very majestic. I'm sure it'll look even more impressive as it soars through the sky.
The eyes and ears glow in the dark, so you're sure to see it at night. Your golden finch is cute too, Yao Yao. It's all thanks to Auntie Cloud Retainer's guidance.
What about your kind of traveler?
Well, how should I say this? Since we had to produce something that is quite realistic and is actually is going to be the talk of the town, then I had but no choice. As you're all staring at me right now, I had but no choice but to create a Paimon flying kite. Because she flies. And is happy while flying. Please stop staring at me. Smug face. Okay. Wow. A Paimon kite. Look at the face of the kite. Like, aw, she's enjoyed that too much. Yeah.
It makes her look like she's already won the competition.
Do not dare speak such words. I'll have you know, I am the master of kite-creating flying competitions.